societal, dealing with society and how the Catholic Church deals with wider society. Tell us, I mean, what are some of these? We've some of these issues include, you know, that are well known, sexual abuse scandals, a shortage of priests, I guess the rise of evangelical churches throughout the Americas. How specifically do you think that the new Pope can address these issues?
Well, I'd like to just say that let's go right into the evangelical sects, S-E-C-T-S. The evangelicals have jumped into a vacuum that we Catholics have created by not being pastoral enough in Latin America. I think another issue would be that at one time and in practice, in many ways, we were seen as sort of owning the turf of Latin America. And now we will have a place, a clear place, Catholic Church, but we must be more complementary and more collaborative than we've been, not only in Latin America, but throughout the world. There may be issues that that we do not agree with as Catholics, but on the other hand, we have to respect the fact that there will be other opinions, and we can and should hold to our identity, but we don't own the turf. That might be a way of expressing in regard to Latin America itself, but I think it is an issue for the larger world too. The issue of sexual inappropriate activity, that has to be dealt with just head on, as I do think the U.S. bishops at this time, in fact, are endeavoring to do. And that would be an issue. I think a listening stance on the part of official leadership, particularly when challenged, is going to be very, very important. And that will get right back to the type and the quality of leadership that would be exercised with Francis, namely through his Secretary of State and the team that he approves, the team that will work with him.
Tell us about, you mentioned a Secretary of State. I'm not sure that many people understand the importance of that. Explain that to us.
Well, I think the Secretary of State would be parallel to the Secretary of State of our own government, the U.S. government. At the same time, a person that makes contacts not only with other governments, the Vatican is a state itself, but also with what they call the nuncios or church representatives in those areas of the world. I think Archbishop John Quinn of San Francisco, a few nights ago at Stanford University, gave a very interesting conference to a large number of people. And one of the key points he made was he feels that from now on, there should be a greater authority also given to regional groups, like the Latin Americans have a regional group of bishops, that they should have a more determining voice throughout the world. This would need to be done. And the Latin Americans really have, with strengths and weaknesses, as a regional group, have followed through in Vatican II very effectively. I admire them for that.
Okay, last...